Hello everyone, welcome to Students Point. This is 21st of November and we are going to see all of the important questions for the day. So pay your attention till the end. And to get PDF of all these videos, you can join us on Telegram by writing the channel's name, Students Point. You can also follow us on Instagram by writing the username, The Students Point. And if you are finding these videos useful, then don't forget to like the video and do share the video with your friends and loved ones. Also don't forget to press the subscribe button and the bell icon to receive the notification at the earliest, so that you never miss any opportunity to learn and grow every day. Now here is the question for the day, and everyone has to answer this question in the comment section. The question is, which city is named as the World Book Capital City for the year 2021? I repeat this question once again for your kind attention, that which city is named as the World Book Capital for the year 2021? These are the options. Read the options carefully, and I hope everyone will pay attention on the question and will answer this question correctly. Okay, let's move ahead. The first question now. Which force is responsible to guard India-Bhutan border? So it is Sashat Seema Bal. So here C is right answer. ITBP is responsible to guard Indo-Chinese border, while Sashat Seema Bal guard India-Bhutan and India-Nepal border. Why a question on India-Bhutan? Because Prime Minister Modi and Bhutanese Prime Minister Lotay Shering has jointly launched RuPay Card Phase 2. It will allow Bhutanese citizens to access RuPay network in India. Next question. World Fisheries Day is celebrated on? So it is celebrated on 21st of November. So here A is right answer. The theme for this year is social responsibility in the fisheries value chain. The third question now. What is the theme of Bengaluru Tech Summit 2020? So its theme is Next is Now. I repeat, Next is Now. So here A is the right answer. Prime Minister recently has inaugurated Bengaluru Tech Summit via video conference, which was also attended by Prime Minister of Australia. The focus of the summit was innovations in the domains of information technology and electronics and biotechnology. The government of Karnataka, along with Karnataka Innovation and Technology Society, has organized it. Next question. Leelavati Award 2020 has been launched by? So it has been launched by Ministry of Education. So here D is the right answer. This award, called as Leelavati Award, is based on a name of a book written by Bhaskara II, who was a great mathematician. Leelavati was actually the son of Bhaskara II, and based on her name, he named his book. And it is All India Council for Technical Education's innovative education program to empower women, and for that reason, this organization has launched this award. The theme of this award is Women Empowerment. Next question. Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge has been launched by? So it has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So here A is the right answer. This award, called as Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge, aims to ensure that no life of septic tank or sewer cleaner is lost during the cleaning. Next question. World Children's Day is being celebrated on? So it was observed last day on 28th of November. This day is UNICEF's Annual Day of Action for Children and by Children. Since 1990, the World Children's Day also marks the anniversary of the date that the United General Assembly adopted both the Declaration and the Convention on Children's Rights. Next question now. Consider the following statements about Vatayan International Awards. These awards are given by Vatayan UK Organization in London. It honors poets, writers, artists for their exemplary work in their respective fields. This is also correct. So this point is, remember that it is given by a UK-based organization. And personalities like Prasoon Joshi, Javed Akhtar have been awarded with this Vatayan Award for their literary contributions. So this is also correct. So here C is the right answer. And Union Education Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank will be conferred with the Vatayan Lifetime Achievement Award at a virtual ceremony today. And if you have found the video useful till now, do like the video and do share the video with your friends and loved ones. Next question now. What is the IUCN status of willow warbler? It is a bird. So it is categorized as least concerned. So here C is the right answer. Why it was in news? Because willow warbler has been sighted for the first time in India at Velayani Punchakari paddy fields in Kerala. They breed throughout the northern and temperate Europe and the Palearctic. What is Palearctic? Palearctic ecozone is one the Earth's eight ecozones. So there are total 8 ecozones in Earth, or Earth has been divided into total 8 ecozones, out of which Palearctic is one of them. And this ecozone covers some area including north of Himalaya in Asia, with parts of Western Asia and most of East Asia. It also covers northern part of Sahara or northern part of Africa, which covers Sahara region. This bird is the longest migrating small birds. Now let's see some more points in news. The Booker Prize of the year 2020 has been won by Douglas Stewart for his debut novel Sagi Payen. I repeat it once again that the Booker Prize for year 2020 has been won by Douglas Stewart for his novel Sagi Payen. Next point now, the Prime Minister of India and Grand Duchy of Luxembourg have held the first ever India-Luxembourg virtual summit. In the summit, the agreement was signed on a strengthening relationship in the post-COVID-19 world, especially in the areas of financial technology, green financing, space applications, digital innovations, and startups. So I hope you find the video useful. Do like and do share the video, subscribe and press the bell icon. We'll meet again in the next video. Until then, stay safe and thanks for watching.